What's going on, guys? Welcome to another video. So today we're still in North Wales, still with Jordan. Here he is. Bit of a revisit. If you've been following me for a while, you will recognize this one. It is the miniature Italian village in North Wales. So it was created by Mark Bourne, George.
Yeah, Mark Bourne, local resident. So what? Because he's inspired by his trips to Italy.
Yeah. So Jordan said that, but it's quite interesting, to be fair. Some of you would have seen it about 2 years ago on the channel, but it's always good to revisit, and we are nearly there now. So let's get into this video.
Right, so I didn't actually notice this last time, so Jordan spotted this, so 5 points to him. This is actually a replica of Paxton's Tower. I've been there before, many moons ago though. Probably before the world got messed up, because I can't say that word. But we're obviously, like I said, at the Italian village again for a little revisit. And you've got all of the stones of different places they come from. Wrexham, that's a place I wouldn't mind going at some point. Chester. And this probably would have taken a long old time to do. A long, long old time. I mean, there's even like post boxes and that. It's mad, isn't it? Little post boxes. And let me know down below if you were a subscriber of mine back when I'd done this, because I want to say I'd done this 2021, because I'd done this in the secret waterfall the same day. But the attention to detail in these buildings is really, really surreal, to be honest. And it goes for quite the stretch as well. But it was nice to even learn the bit of history that Jordan found about it. So John Bone, inspired by his travels to Italy and his love for Italy, decided to make this. And as you can see, there's obviously more bricks with the places they've come from. And then what I also like about this is, because obviously leaves and I've grown around it, it sort of gives that derelict vibe. And it's just an interesting place. There is some over there, but they really hard to be to, you know, see. And it is a private house. So, but you even have like whatever this is. Someone let me know in the comments what it is. You have moon faces as well. Normally water comes out of there, but we haven't had rain in a few days, which is rare for Wales, if I'm honest. But the derelict vibe to it, because of all the leaves and that growing over it, it's really, really cool. And you can see sort of the Italian inspiration behind it. I'm just gutted they didn't have the plague doctor island, Porfavella, that's what it's called. Have a look. It would have had a cool little, cool little statue of Porfavella. But the architecture that went into this was something crazy. I don't see why the owner don't open the garden up, charge people a few quid, make some money off it. And then it goes into a forest, which is really, really, really cool vibes, to be honest. Wilfred Owen. I can't say that, but Austria, 1893. But just, what a cool place.
Hello.
No. Right, so that's the Italian village. If you haven't seen it before, I hope you enjoyed it. If you have seen it before, then thank you for being a loyal follower, because that was about 3-ish years ago. If you are new to the channel, please consider subscribing for unique content like this, you know, just the van life stuff and all that sort of good stuff. Make sure you check out Jordan's perspective as well, because his link will be in the description. If you could like, comment, subscribe if you're new, and I will see you all soon. Peace.